Shown above is a single-source electropherogram, that is, the electropherogram of a sample that is known to represent only one person's DNA. In order to help the analyst more easily derive useful information from the electropherogram, profiling software determines the number of STRs represented by each peak and labels them all accordingly. Notice that the red peaks are disregarded during profiling, as they merely represent the size standard used during electrophoresis. The resulting chart of labeled peaks is the sample contributor's STR profile. When a sample or samples are provided to an analyzing lab, the lab will deliver a report on the profile of each contributor found in the samples. This report will list the alleles in a table, labeled according to the number of STRs each has, and categorized according to contributor and the dye with which they were identified, which indicates the locus. Any one sample may require more than one series of tests in order to identify all of its alleles. Notice that the table is already partially filled in from a previous series of tests that were performed on this sample. Click Next to view all three charts. Compare the electropherogram that is produced by the initial analysis to the corresponding profile, to the final results table that presents the profile data from the testing of all 13 core loci. Move the mouse cursor over the profile labels to see where those alleles are listed on the results table.